Hey guys, it's Van DZLM, back with Carpe Vanguard Deck Profile. So hope you guys enjoy. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and subscribe. This time we are covering DZLM set 1, Michu. So DZ just dropped, or like this week it's dropping its first set for Lyrical Monasterio focused deck set 1. And I decided let's do deck profiles on all of them. And for some reason I chose this is the acronym I'm gonna call them all by. So yeah, let's go. I don't know why, it's really fun saying DZLM. Anyways, let's start, shall we, with probably my favorite deck straight up coming out of like the original when they all came out, like, you know, Lutetia, Michu, Kyoka, all that stuff when they all came out originally. Probably my favorite deck among them, and while not necessarily my favorite now, it's still like within the top three of the ones that we got support in this deck with. So let's go and see what we got here, because honestly, this deck is actually really fun to play, and this is the one I want to do the deck profile the most. In fact, that's the only reason I'm recording this now. Anyways, Energy Generator. First up, it's our Ride Deck Crest. You may Ride Deck Crest in your Ride Deck. Auto Ride Deck. When put into your Ride, when you ride, put this card into your Crest Zone. If you win second, Energy Charge 3. Continuous, may have to 10 Energy and Auto Begin your Ride Phase. Energy Charge 3. Then act once per turn. Energy Boss 7. Draw a card. Standard Energy Crest. You get the free 3 energy, and then you every ride phase, and then you possibly get the free draw card by energy blasting 7. This deck does not use up that much energy. I'm trying to remember who is in this deck, because I haven't looked at this deck in like 2 days, but this deck does not use up too much energy, so you get a little bit freebie here and there with that draw skill, which is nice to have. So obviously this is a ride deck crest, because they have yet to print more of them. And of course, we have our Grade 0, which is Afternoon Dance Lesson Michu. Grade 0 boost, 5k Shosuke base, auto roll power for second, draw a card, standard starting splash free draw if you go second. I just like her as a starter. Also, I'm pretty sure the Grade 1 requires her as the starter. I'm a little bit tired today, so if I seem like a little bit 50-50 on like where I'm at mentally, that's probably why. But yes, the Grade 1 does require the Grade 0 Michu as the starter. So she's a nice to have in the Riot deck, and I don't know why, I just like the cannonballs over here in her background. Then we have our triggers. We're on our Overtrigger, Greatest Star of Tanza, Grade 0 boost, 50k Shield, 5k power, Overtrigger, move trigger in your deck, reveal it, add trigger, move that card, draw a card, choose one of these, against movement for the turn, and reveal it during your check, activate its additional effect, which you get during this fight, you get during your turn, all your front rear guards, not all your front rear guards, all your rear guards get plus tons of power, which all around is pretty solid, because, you know, regardless of who gets the melee or not, regardless of which turn it is, either is hitting that turn regardless, unless you have, your opponent has a PG, or is not getting hit that turn unless your opponent pulls their own over, but when you drive check this, your entire rear guard gets plus 10. In a deck that can aggro and get more numbers, this basically turns your entire rear guard, which is already a beatstick bomb attack, into a bigger beatstick bomb attack, which I... Like, cool. I really miss that fact about, like, G, kind of, that D and V, V kind of had it, but, like, D took away from it, where a lot more decks in D focused on restanding and a little bit of extra critical. Well, G and V definitely had, let's just make everything big beat sticks. But yeah, this definitely returns the feelings. You get numbers. It's very nice to have. You can run Vaughn up for multi-attack. You can run the Dark Overtrigger that can heal and call. But I'd rather have big beat stick, because this lasts for the entire game. So if you pull it early enough, well, your opponent's going to have a fun time trying to stop you. Then we have our normal triggers, because I've been doing this since set 3. I really don't know why I'm still doing this. I very am confused of how this started into, like, as just a one deck thing, and then it, like, turned into a trend for all of my decks now. Anyways, 2 of Transparent Snow Knight Baratoy, 2 Snow Skip Pavi. Both are grade 0s with boost 4k power. The difference is Pavi has 15,000 shield, Baratoy has 5,000 shield, and they both have the same effect of continuous guard circle. Opponent's vanguards are grade 3 or greater, they get 5k shields. You know, Pavi is a 20k shield, which is nice to have, and Baratoy is a 10k shield, which is also nice to have, and their respective triggers, Baratoy being a draw, so, you know, she's very nice for helping increase your hand to get more of your cannonballs out of deck and more of your persona rise and stuff like that. While Pavi, more numbers. That's why Pavi's here. More numbers. You can get rid of Pavi altogether and put Baratoy up to 3 and then put Godleave up to 4, so you have a total of 8 crits and 3 draws. But again, for some reason, this is a trend that I don't even understand why I'm still going with it. But also the fact that, like, the front 10k is very helpful, especially defensively, where you, especially if you're like me, where you're constantly calling all of your cards to the board for aggro. So being able to defend all of your entire front row with just one single trigger is pretty nice. And again, the 20k shield is actually helpful in very specific situations in case you're fighting like another beatstick deck and they're hitting for good numbers. So 2 of Pavi, 2 of Baratoy. Then we have 7 crits, 3 Fluffy Lady Godleave, Grade 0 boost, 20k shield, 5k power. This can really be any crit you want. I just used to make it her because I used it as a template for whichever of the Lyrical Monasterio decks was the first one to get support. I think it was Medeol, because I wanted to give them all like 7 or 8 crits. And then I just kept doing that for all of the decks, so I just never changed them. So So God Leave is now the official like critical trigger that I run in all my Lyrical Monasterio decks. And then we have four copies of Precious Tune Edwidge. Great Zoo Boost, Finding Kishio, 4k power, critical trigger, auto rear, then battle the boost to shove to soul to one of your units get 2k for the turn. Okay, someone gets 2k. Unless it's a very specific unit in a very specific situation, that's not gonna make too much of a difference. But it is a free soul card, so if you are soul spamming like hell and you are not getting your soul charges off for whatever reason that may be, Edwidge is definitely a nice rear guard addition for you. Again, God Leave can be whatever, but either way, we run 7 crits for the big beat sticks, 2 fronts for bigger beat sticks, and defensive options in Bear Toy, because why not? Then we, of course, have our 4 heals in Peaceful Guardian Ika, Great Zoe Boost, Finicate Shield, 5k Power. Like how God Leave is the standard crit, Anika is the standard heal, where this was back, I think, in set 2 for Lyrical Monasterio, where I just didn't change the heal when I was copying it over to other decks. So she is now just, like, my official Lyrical Monasterio heal. And, yeah, when I want her to show up, show up. What I mean by this is there have been games, not just in this deck, but just, like, consistently overall Lyrical Monasterio, where I will sack 3 of her back-to-back, all of which go off. Like, I do not understand. Like, there will be no cards interrupting all 3 of them, and there will be, like, all 3 of them go off back to back to back, and I will sit there on the side that's trying to win and be like, oh, great, Scott, we're doing this again. 4 of Anika. Very good grade 0. You can really make this any heal you want. You can make counter heals. I just make it Anika because A, I'm too lazy to change it, and B, at this point, she's proven that I just should run her as my heal trigger. Then move on to our grade 1s. 4 copies, and I'm pretty sure everyone disagrees with me on this, but I don't care, of all set up. Grade 1, set order, set order's play, put it to order zone, act order zone. If your Vanguard's a Michu, rest this card, soul charge 1, choose 1 cannonball from your hand, put it to order zone. Okay, it is a free, non-mandatory, soul charge 1, put an extra card into your order zone, which is great, so you know you can spam out more soul very easily, and a lot of people only play this on 1, which is fair, because your main grade 1 of the ride deck literally just auto-searches this for you. And the reason why I run it at 4 is because, A, I don't like seeing 1-ups. I think the only deck I'm willing to do that in is Bavsagra, and the only reason I do that in Bavsagra is because we have more arm cards, and I also don't like the fact that the one that we have to run as a 1-up is the defensive card. But all setup is just a nice card to have, because it also deck thins for triggers, which sounds like it works. It doesn't, or at least it doesn't the way you think it does, because I'll just soul charge triggers off this, but then I'll just sack more triggers off of the drive checks. So, I don't know. All setup is nice. It also gets more cannonballs into order zone, like I said, so it's a nice way to get you set up, and if they ever make another Michu that for some reason gets rid of 2 cannonballs in a turn, you got that bonus. So, 4 of all setup. Nice card to have. If you're smart, run it as a 1 of, but I just choose to keep it at 4 because I like the art and I think it's good. Let me have 4 copies of Waiting for This Day, Rafiki. Okay, so there is a card in here that costs energy blast 3. Anyways, Grid on Boost, 5 Kishiro, AK Base. On one place on Mirror Guard, so we have all set up in your order zone. Energy blast 3, check top 7, 2 up to 1 cannonball from Mundlum, reveal, put your hand, shuffle your deck. So the fact is, if you're going second, you can just get the all set up from your grade 1 of the ride deck. Then because you went second, you get the 3 for energy from your energy generator. Then you just play her, and then you auto get a cannonball if it's in your top 7. Pretty solid. Then act rear guard. If your Vanguard's a grade 3 card with Michu in his card name, shove this card to soul, shift to 1 glistening mood Michu, ride it as standard, shuffle your deck, and if your Vanguard was placed during the ride phase this turn or your Persona Rolled this turn, you can activate Persona Rolled to end of turn if Persona Rolled effects active, even if for Persona Rolled active for normal effects. So, the important thing to note here is all the other grade 4, not all the other grade 4 decks, all the other, the glitter decks had to wait until their grade 1 was printed as a promo to get superior rides. Michu got it in the same set that she evolved. Fun. Either way, though, very good grade 1. It's a nice card to early game rush your opponent with, and as we've made it very clear, I love to early game rush people. Not to mention the fact that she's a free soul charger, so if you really are just spam souling yourself down to death, you can use her skill to increase your soul and get that free superior ride, which technically speaking, you can do the turn you ride to grade 3. You're just not gonna get the persona ride benefits off of it. Either way, though, she's a very solid grade 1, and I give her a 4 for that. Also, I just really like her, like, star art, and it's mainly because she's the most unique one, or, like, one of the only unique ones in the entirety of the set 2 booster, or set 1 booster, simply because a lot of them just have a starry background, and while she kind of does, she doesn't have, like, big stars visible in the background. Like, she has small ones here and there, but that's pretty much it. So 4 of her. Then we have 4 copies of Shy Vocal No Queen. Grade 1 boost, 5k short, 8k base. Auto drop zone with this card, put into your order zone. When a card is put into your order zone, not with this card. If you do not have a unit with No Queen No in this card name, I forgot to change the English on there. Soul Blast 1 calls card to back row rear guard circle. If there are only 2 copies of this card in drop zone, you may only call 1. It does have to go to back row center though, but either way, being able to call itself batches by setting an order is nice because, you know, Again, search your deck for the grade one set up order when you ride into her. After you discard her for ride deck, then just play all set up and then immediately call her by Soul Blasting Star, which is pretty solid. And then Glitter Michu, your Vanguard's a Glitter. Auto back or rear guard center. At the end of all your Vanguard attack, if your opponent's Vanguard's a grade three guard, counter boss one, ditch one to stand this unit. And then this unit exchanges position with your Vanguard, and at the end of your turn, exchange the swapped unit's positions. Your soul does not change. The reason why it says all of this is because changing the unit's position means this unit keeps its power buffs. So if you use Michu's effect and give this thing power, or you sack triggers and you give it power, well, she's just gonna keep the power outright, and yes, she does have drive check. So basically, she has the ability to give you triple drive for that entire turn, which is pretty solid. All around, Noquino is a very good grade one. She allows for like a little bit early game setup if you discard her for Riot deck, not to mention the fact that once you hit grade three, you're always gonna have two Vanguard attacks, more or less. So she's a very nice card to have, and I do like her as a four of. Number 4 copies of RPG, Soul Beast Splash, Ravinia. Grade 1 boost, 0 Soul's K. Base can change Seth Nomad for 4 Sentinels in deck. I must put on Guard Circle. Choose one mutes. It cannot be hit till the battle. If I hand 2 more cards in it, choose a card from hand, discard it, standard PG. Nothing to specify about it. Basically, that means if there's only one of the cards in your hand, you place it on Guard Circle, you don't have to score great, because that means you can be as aggressive as you want in the early game. And by aggressive, I mean you just spam the hell out of these guys and these ones. And then when your opponent eventually counterattacks you, you throw down Ravinia, and then you don't have to score anything because you have a low amount of hand cards. All around Ravinia is a very solid PG. You can run any of the Lyrical Monasterio PGs because they all have the exact same skill. I just make it Ravinia because, I don't know, I feel like Ravinia fits this deck's theme really well, so that's that. Then we move on to Charles, grade 1 on the deck, 1 on the ride deck, and on the main deck of Happy Shopping Michu, grade 1 boost, 5k shield, 8k base, auto in place by riding from a grade 0 with Michu in his card name. Search your deck for up to 1 all set up, put it to your order zone and shuffle your deck. Glitter, it can only recite the fire regalers. I still don't know what those are. Either way though, being able to search your deck for the all set up order is solid because it also auto puts it into your order zone, I might add, which means if you have a second one in your hand, you can just play that one. And there's also important because if you play a more Soul Blast heavy version of this deck, like basically the one that runs all those cards of Soul Blast, bot deck themselves to draw a card and get a bunch of benefits, well, you can just spam a bunch of all setups and get a free soul charge, considering this allows you to technically play 2 when you hit grade 1. So Michu is a very solid grade 1. I do like her skill a lot. I think she's nice. She definitely combos well with Noquino to get you all set up. Aha, see what I did there? I don't know. When I'm tired, it sounds like I'm being sarcastic. Anyways, one of in the ride deck of Michu, none of the main deck. She's a nice grade one to have, and she's one of my favorite cards in terms of art for Lyrical Monasterio overall. Then move on to our grade 2s. 4 copies of Revere 1 Milagros, grade 2 and set 5k shield, 10k base. Auto, he's placed on rear guard circle. If a Vanguard of Michu in his card name, send a hand card into your soul. Choose a cannonball from your drop zone, bounce it to hand. If your damage zone has 3 or more face down cards in it, you do not countercharge the turn, countercharge 1. I always love it that the situations that I need a cannonball are never the situations where I need to countercharge, but always the situation right after I fetch the cannonball, I need to be in the countercharge situation, and I already use my 1 of Milagros that I get the entire game on trying to recycle the cannonball. Either way though, she's a very good card for that ability. You know, she gets you more soul cards, and she does recycle your cannonballs, so you can keep using them over and over and over again, which is very nice in case you only saw one throughout the entire game. I've been in that situation before, and thankfully Milagros was there for me when I needed her most. And you know, if you do end up getting 2 start timing properly like I would like to, you do get the counter charge 1, which is a nice addition. And then continues to rear guard if your cannonball card was put into your order zone, was put from your order zone to the drop zone this turn, plus on the power. So she's already at 20k, plus probably your other front or rear guard to 20k, plus the Vanguard whose cannonball skill is just give 3 of your units plus 10k, plus your restanding grade 1. Yeah, you pretty much have B6 on steroids here. Hell, maybe let's even throw in the overtrigger just for more numbers, because why the hell not? Either way though, Milagros is a very solid grade 2, acts as a B-stick, gets you counter charge, what's like about her, easy 4 of. Then we have Star Song Prayer Noquino. Grade 2, intercept, 5k shield, 10k base. The second I saw her first effect, I automatically knew I loved her. The second I saw her third effect, I automatically knew I liked her more. Continuous rear guard. If your cannonball card is put into your order zone, to your drop zone this turn, plus 10,000 power. 20k beat stick. So we have 2 of them. We have 2 only requiring the cannonball card to go to drop zone, 20k beat stick grade 2s. Cool. Second skill, Glitter, Michu. If your Vanguard's a Glitter with Michu in his card name, act, rear guard, once per turn. If your Vanguard's a grade 3 or greater, counter boss 1, soul boss 1, this unit gets auto rear guard when it swings into anything. If no draft checks are performed for the battle, your rear guard attack this turn, this unit performs draft checks to the end of that battle until end of turn. Now, the important part is, yes, if you have 2 of these on board, technically you can proc the skill twice, but because it has to be for the battles your rear guards didn't attack, basically, you pay the cost to give them both the skill, but only one of them would actually do drive checks. So you can do the cost twice, it's just not going to do anything for you. But Anyways, being able to get drive checks, plus your already inherent twin drive with the skill of your restanding grade one over here, that's quad drive right there, and your rear guard that does it has at least 20 to 30k. So, Naquino's just a good card. Oh, one more thing I forgot to mention. Well, yeah, this one requires you to be at, your opponent to be at grade three. This just requires you to be at grade three. So you can do this while they're at grade two. Four of. 20k beat stick, only costs 1 CB, only costs 1 soul blast. Oh, look who gets you both resources in one go, possibly. And gives you drive checks. All while your opponent's at grade 2. Even though this deck only has like 4 attacks and doesn't really dabble with extra criticals, hell, it could just lose the 4th attack. And if they gave us one more card, which is like a bunch of power gain skill, this deck would just still be as good, simply because it's just beat sticks on steroids. Hell, I don't even think they would have to give us another beat stick card. They would just have to take, they could just take away the 4th attack, and automatically the deck would still be at, not as good, but obviously because you lost something, but still good, because big beat sticks. Either way, Naquino's a good 4 of. I just like her a lot. I think she's really cool. Then we have last grade 2 in the deck, one of them in the red deck, then on the main deck of Sparkling Summer Michu, grade 2 and SF5 Kishio, Tanka Base, auto placed by riding from a grade 1 Michu in his card name. Check top 5, flip to 1 card with Naquino. Again, I forgot to change the name on that one. Or a cannonball card, will put your hand shuffle your deck. So either get your free cannonball, which shows up like once or twice a game, or get yourself a free Naquino who can either restand or get you drive checks. Cool. I like this grade 2 a lot. I think she's very nice. One of in the riot deck, none in the main deck, because obviously no rear guard skills, but hey, it's free search, so free search is good. Then on to grade 3s. 4 copies of Flower Cannonball, which I always forget cost a counterblast, but to be I also forgot that it gets you a free draw. Okay, that's interesting, but you will almost never use that counterblast skill to place it, because that's pretty much when you play it normally, when you have cards like, I don't know, all set up, which can kind of play it for free, more or less. So, you know, there's that. Anyways, auto-wounds, put it to order zone, whether you play it normally or whether you superior place it, draw a card, so free draw, which is nice, and then act order zone if you have a grade 3 or greater card with Michu in his card name. So put this card into your drop zone, and then change all of your Vanguard's cannonball abilities to auto-Vanguard. Once you attack, Soul Blast 2, choose 3 of your units, plus 10,000 power to each of them until end of the turn. So, cool. Pretty much, you take your Vanguard, you swing with it, you do the skills, you get this plus 10k, even though it already got another 10k from this, is going into the drop zone regularly. So, you know, this got 10k from its own skill, so 20. It got another 10k from the Vanguard skill, so 30. This is probably getting 10k from the Vanguard skill, so you can restand with it, so 18k. And maybe the Vanguard or another rear guard gets 10k. It really just depends on the situation. Either way, though, this card is good. It's free conditionally. It only costs 1 CB in all, technically, to do all this, which just is its place cost. And to be fair, you are never going to place it normally. That's why all setup is here. So, yeah, 4 Flower Cannonball. There is another Cannonball promo, but A, I don't know if it's in English or not, and B, it doesn't change, at least in my memory, it doesn't change the Cannonball effect, so I just chose not to run it, so, you know, might as well go for the one that actually gets you numbers and basically makes everything B6 on steroids. So, 4 Flower Cannonball. Then we have 2 copies of, this can really be whatever you want, I only ran her here because, I mean, might as well run the new unit, that's actually why she's here. Starry Sky, Lucetta, grade 3, 200 personality, 13k base, act rear guard once per turn, when your cannonball card is put into your drop zone from the order zone, put a grade 3 card from your drop zone above deck, plus 10,000 power to her. Okay, she can recycle your cannonballs, should you? No, because you have options to get them back from drop zone. Do not send this back to deck, because you can't really shuffle for it unless you have a copy of this in your hand. And even then, you're not going to get it on that first shot unless you have more cannonballs left in deck. Either way, though, Lucetta is a decent grade 3. I mean, 23k beat stick, which is nice, plus maybe your choice from the 10k that you're going to get from the cannonball, so 33k. Hell, maybe even Persona Ride, so 43k. So she is good for that magic number hitting, but again, all of your units, at least that you want in the front row, are going to be beat sticks anyways, so you don't really need her. You can replace her for anything you want, really. I just keep it Lucetta just because, I mean, it's a new card, and if you do end up playing her in the front row, it does hit the magic number, so 2 of. Then we have 4 copies of Glistening Mood Michu. Grade 3, Tundra, Persona Ride, 13k base. Auto when placed by riding from first to head towards a Dream Michu, search your deck or drop zone for up to 1 card with Naquino in its card name or up to 1 cannonball. Reveal it, put it to your hand, and if you search your deck, you shuffle it, and activate Persona Ride. So you get one of 3 cards here. You either get Thing That Enables Plays, things that's a beat stick or restander. So if you already have two of the three, automatically you get the third one for yourself for free, or you can just pick whatever is best to your situation. Or if you're me in the one on camera game that I did with this deck, you can gamble on the fact that you're going to top deck a grade 2 off her persona ride and flip it anyways, and whoop-de-effin-do, it works. So either way, it's that skill is just good inherently. And the act Vanguard, once per turn, bind a copy of First Head Towards the Dream Michu from your soul, choose an opponent's rear guard, murder it, and to end of turn, reduce the cost of this unit's Kindling Ball ability by 2, and then Soul Boss 2, by the way. At the end of your turn, if this unit is your Vanguard, ride the bound card for this cost as rest. So, rear guard murder, and makes your Cannonball ability free. So basically what you want, but specifically because it also has its own Cannonball ability, you're going to want to activate this card's effect first to change its Cannonball ability, then bind the card so you don't have to pay the cost. And the other skill is Cannonball Auto Vanguard. When this unit attacks into a Vanguard, Soul Boss 2, choose one of your opponent's rear guards, murder it, plus the power for that battle. Okay, here's what you're going to do here. You're going to, if you really want to kill your opponent on first grade, 3 turn, regardless of what grade their Vanguard's at, ride First Head to Dwarves Dream, meet you, Kyra Boss 1, draw a card, call a card from her skill. Make sure you have at least one of these on your board, because this isn't going to do anything for you. Then what you're going to want to do is get this card into your order zone by any means necessary. Send this card to Soul while you're on this. Superior ride into this. You're not going to proc the persona ride, but she will proc the free search skill, which is nice. And then you change your Cannonball skill with this one. Then you bind out the copy of Michu from your soul. Then you murder your opponent's rear guards, give yourself the free 10k to 3 units, and then you automatically just rush your opponent down from there. Convoluted combo, yes, but none of that costs a CB outside of Michu herself, so that's fun. Either way, though, very solid card. You know, one way or another, she's getting a rear guard retire, and she's at least getting good numbers out of this, and she gets you a free search, which can technically lead to comeback combos. So I like listening mood Michu a lot. I think this is a very nice evolution to her, and just a good inheritance of her skills, so 4 of. Then we have our last card in the deck, one of in the ride deck, none in the main deck, because my personal opinion, you don't need it in the main deck, and that is First to Head Towards a Dream, Michu. Grade 3, 200 persona, 13k base, act Vanguard, once per turn if your order zone has all set up in your order zone, counter boss 1, draw a card, choose a card from your hand, call it to rear guard, circle, or discard it. I always hated this skill, which is why I originally hated Michu, because it was literally the exact same skill verbatim from Leonorn from Booster Set 6, except the only difference was Leonore did not require an extra card in your order zone to proc that skill. Though, I don't mind it here, because her Cannonball ability is Auto Van, when this you attacks on anything, Soul Boss 2, choose opponent's rear guard, murder, plus 5 power. So pretty much it does the same thing as this card's Cannonball ability, but like 5k less, which again, I'm glad that like this is almost just a straight up upgrade from that. But being able to call anything is still very solid, because it does increase your hand, it gives you the chance to hit any of these cards, and it also gives you the chance to proc off her skill a little bit more consistently, which is nice. If only I drew her more consistently, that'd be great. But either way though, she's a very good grade 3 to have. She gets you rear guard. She's not a bad card to sit on, especially because she is still affectable by Flower Cannonball. But once you hit onto this Michu, well, numbers out the wazoo, and you're getting that rear guard kill regardless, which is pretty solid. And that's it for this deck, so I hope you guys enjoyed. All around, this deck is actually very fun. I do like the fact that it's just numbers galore. It makes it feel really unique among the rest of the D decks, where it's really all are just like extra crits and extra attacks. And some of them are like beat stick decks, like Prison can be a beat stick deck if you play it a certain way. But, you know, it's nice to have a deck that's just fully more focused on gaining power than anything else. Hell, this is more of a DP deck than DP. Either way, though, I'm just going to hear. I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, join us for Twitch. I'll see you on this one. Switch up your Vanguards. I'm not going to do that.